Hello everybody and welcome to a special Ergobits. We normally publish these videos monthly, but we couldn't wait to share all the good news. After a few struggles, the Race 2 production line is running at full capacity. We just released Bazecor 1.6 with many quality of life improvements, and we are very close to the official release of the Defy 2.0 firmware. Last but definitely not least, we also have great deals for Black Friday that we don't want you to miss. We're on a roll, baby. Let's start from the top, the Dygma Race 2 manufacturing. A couple of weeks ago, we were in a bit of a pickle. We were unsatisfied with the quality of the top panels we received. They had micrometric cracks near the bends, and we had to reject many. That meant the production line was not running at full capacity, and it would take more time to assemble and ship all the keyboards. The supplier promised to ramp up production to compensate, and they did. But we knew that the rejection rate that high was not sustainable, so we worked with them to fix it. In the end, it was as simple as changing the type of aluminum for one that was slightly more flexible and less prone to presenting those microscopic cracks when stamped. The other small crisis has been the palm pads. You can't imagine the headaches that something so apparently simple has given us. This time, it wasn't even us who rejected them in our incoming quality control. They didn't even dare send them. So for a time, we had a few hundred keyboards waiting for the palm pads. Now that's solved and they're no longer blocking manufacturing, but our head product manager was just about to head to the airport. The great news is that all that is water under the bridge and we're now assembling like crazy.
I want to see those machines working 24 hours a day. We're gonna make this place feel like a nightclub, you know what I mean? Chicky boom, chicky boom, chicky boom.
So far, we've assembled and shipped all black full-spec English US keyboards with all the switches. If you have that configuration and haven't received your tracking number yet, you should receive it in a couple of days. The only orders of black full-spec US English keyboards that haven't shipped are those with the extra palm pads, which we will be shipping soon. It might not seem like much, but that's 30% of the manufacturing run. We hope to finish all black keyboards by the end of next week, representing about 70% of the run. Then we will move to the silver keyboards, which will be assembled by mid-December. Remember, you'll get an email with a tracking number once your keyboard ships. But if you simply cannot wait, you can join our subreddit or Discord to check our weekly shipping updates. Once you receive your keyboard, the first thing you should do is install Bazecor. We have recently released Bazecor 1.6 with a ton of improvements and the usual bug fixing. Mikael asked me if he could be the one to tell you all about this release's new features. And since I'm so magnanimous, I'm going to let him. As long as he knows who's boss.
Thanks, Dominique. Okay, let's go. The first thing that's new is telling you what's new. We've added a new pop-up with the release notes that shows up the first time you open Bazecor after an update. For this Bazecor 1.6, for example, we've added more support for syncing the OG Race and the Race 2. You can now import old OG Race layers to the Race 2. Before, it only worked with more recent layers. And for those of you who own a Race 2 and an OG Race and want to keep them in sync, we have good news. You can now import backups from the Race 2 to the OG Race. Another quality of life improvement we've added has to do with macros. You can now export and import macros individually, and we've added the option to edit delays on your macro timeline. Let me show you. You go to your macro, you press the cog button, and then you can press export macro or import macro. And if you add a delay, let's say 50 milliseconds, and then you say, oh, I want to change it. Let's change it to 100 milliseconds. You just select it, press select 100, and then there you go. You have a 100 millisecond delay, which if you don't like, you can also delete. We also fixed a bug when saving long macros over Bluetooth. Sometimes the changes were not saved. And we've improved overall consistency when loading and saving changes over Bluetooth. These fixes work best with the latest firmware releases. This week, we have released the Defy 2.0 Beta 9 firmware and the Race 1.1.1 Beta firmware. For this release, we have greatly improved the efficiency of the code on the neuron, requiring less computing power to perform the same operations. This will help eliminate any possible memory leaks and increase overall stability, including smoother firmware updates. We are now working on porting this firmware for the wire neuron of the Defy and fixing some weird LED bugs over Bluetooth, and we'll be ready for a stable release. And now, back to you, Dominique. Or should I say, the boss.
Thanks, Mikkel.
You're gonna be popular.
To wrap up this special Ergobits, let me remind you of the awesome deals we have for Black Friday. You can get a Dygma Defy or Dygma Raise 2 with 10% off. If you're still unsure which one to get, watch this video comparing them. But don't think about it too long. The offer ends on Monday, December 2nd. And that's not the only deal. You can also get 20% off all accessories such as keycaps, switches, palm pads, cables, travel cases, and even top panels for the Defy and the OG Raise. And for those feeling special, we still have a few units left of the limited edition colors of the Dygma Defy and the OG Dygma Raise. You can get them at $100 off. So there are no excuses to just get one and spice up your setup. You just need to choose the color you like best. Red, blue, purple, or gold. And that's it. Head over to Dygma.com/black-friday and secure your deal before they're gone. Remember, these discounts will disappear on the night of December 2. By the way, happy Thanksgiving. Bye.